explores. I mean, this huge old high school in Illinois. It's huge, so it's kind of on my bucket list, so I'm not sure what's left in it. Looks like they're getting ready, they're tearing it down, so figured we'd get a look at it before they do, so get to it.
Wow. Here's the gym. Mold going on the ceiling. The floor's in pretty cool shape though. It's a shame they couldn't save it. This is pretty cool. 82, 83 Class A state champions. 68-0. That's a hell of a feat. Still see the floor under there. It's a damn shame. It's the stage area. Yeah, there's another one. 72-74 state champs. I'm sure they're gonna not dispose of that. A little stuffy. That would have been the announcer's area. As you can tell, the ceiling's probably been leaking. It fell in. Thank you. stage. Stage is pretty rotten. It's one of the locker rooms. A little humid today, so. Another locker room. Whew. Like a catwalk for the gym. Whatchamacallit. This place is massive. It's like four levels in the front. It's another locker room with everything slammed. I think this would be under the stage. You see it right there. Where they lost the uniforms. Probably the football coach's office. That's pretty cool. Trying to breathe through my shirt as best I can. This is below the showers. You can see the bleachers would be above us. This had been empty for quite a bit. This was maybe some offices. These old radiators are really cool. Utility area where they do the so we get upstairs. Skins. I still got the lockers. I think it's really cool. It looks like they're actively. This must have burned. It's got no roof. See, this collapsed pretty good. These little radiators. Just think how many kids run through here over the years. Upper concourse of the gym. This would have been a Wayne McCool's restroom, I think. Yep. Little cubby hole. Napkin dispenser. Where they would have done their hair and makeup and stuff. the stair landing's got two sides to it. So cool. Another room. A lot of these old rooms would have two doors. They had to upgrade it for the air conditioning. Those little places for coats is cool. I've seen that before. Social studies, geography. Click it or kick it. I'm gonna head up to the third floor. Molding up there. I'll try to do some research on this, see when it closed, when it was built. These were supplies. Pretty damn cool. Here's the old sign. Done a few schools, but nothing this big. This is definitely on my bucket list. This probably would have been the librarian's area. Old heaters. That's where they would have stored supplies. Yearbooks, maybe. See this where it's where it burnt and fell in. Flagpole walkway is cool. It's like a little atrium area, maybe. Thank you. storage area. Some desk. Introduction to computers. Lab companion. Probably since it's close to the library, but an old, what do they call those? You put the thing on there and it would put it on the projector onto the screen. Pretty cool. VHS tapes, computer monitors. Go up to the next level. I'm gonna have to restart a minute. Almost 30 minutes. There's a better look at that. Other area. See the stair post right over there. Visual education. A little stage. The teacher would sit. Music. Mrs. LeGrand was the band teacher. Got carpet up here. I've never been to this town before, so I figure I'd just drive across the state line and come here and find this. It's pretty amazing. Yeah, this would have been where they stored band equipment. All right, guys, I'm gonna shut it off, walk down the stairs, and see what else I can find. I'm down here on the second floor. I just think these stairs are cool. How they're split and they come up. Was really loud. You could tell the age of this building by the bricks. Yeah, I think there's, I have to go on the other side of that other part of it. This was the main area where all the trophies and stuff were. Ticket offices for the basketball games. Get some exterior shots in a minute. Head back across, go outside. These old gyms are so cool. This place got loud. It's funny, all the basketball goals on the side doors are still standing. This hill. And there's doors for the bleachers. I'm gonna say this is the old part. Just by the architecture. I catch my breath. If you look at the top of that. Alright guys, I'm gonna pause this, catch my breath. Well, here's the football field. This right here would have been the track because it goes on the outside of the field. As you can see the scoreboard. I don't know if the bleachers are still. There's the restroom. There's a set of stairs. Sure, when you got in trouble, you had to run those. Looks like they already tore the bleachers down. I'm pooped. And there's a scoreboard and goalpost. I think that's it, guys. I'm gonna take some pics, go get some water, cool off. Hope you guys enjoy this. Let's see, it's gonna be pretty cool, I really think. So, see you guys on the flip side. Peace out. Love you. Hey, explorers. Hey, explorers. Back at this old high school in Lawrenceville. I was so tired the other day, I didn't really get a good view of the field, so I've come back to check it out. So, let's see what we can see. I believe this here is the track. As you can see, the cinder goes around the outside of the field. This looks like the old concession stand area. Still got the cups in here. Cups and lids. These are the chains. They'd lift those up, chain them up, that way you can hold up. People could come in. Toilets. See the L, the H, and the S. Lawrenceville High School. Yeah, the same, it's got three pissers. Somebody's been pooping in there, that's gross. They still left the lights and goalpost, scoreboard, press box.
Kitty friend.
I'm not gonna climb this whole thing. It's just steps running up to the school. Wow, there's a big old groundhog up there. Let's see if I can see him. Yeah, the bleachers would have been right here. The home bleachers. A lot of these old schools, I noticed in Illinois, if they're near some kind of river or something, they always build the school up on the river. You know, they build the football field and stuff down below, so you know, floods is not a real big deal. see right up there. There's the loudspeakers. And it looks like part of the old press box. Yeah, it looks like they tore all the bleachers out. Might have reused them. Can't tell if that's a snake or not, so I'm not going in there. Looks like there's the old concrete pillars that supported the big light poles. Power box. Now, this was used until 2013. The 2013 season would have been played at the new high school they built out on the west side of town. I like that one tree growing up there, it's kind of cool. There's the play clock. I believe this area over here would have been maybe like baseball, softball field type thing. Practice field. It looks like there's an old makeshift goalpost. Pretty cool. There's the scoreboard. Building right here had stuff in it. Home guest. You can still see the little L for Lawrence, the Lance for, they were the Indians. almost. This would have been the press box for the visitors. This might have been the track. I'm not sure. This concrete. Where they had the foundation for the bleachers. Probably had bleachers on each side of this little press box. I would guess. Yeah, because the concrete ends right here. There's definitely deer in here. You can see where they have their lays. See the stairs going up to the press box. Probably what it was. They probably had two sets of bleachers. One here, one on that side. So the press box didn't distort the view. Yeah, this was the track. That's the Embarrass River. I guess that's how you pronounce it. Embarrass. Embarrass. Here's a good view of the school. This is the new part. You can just imagine the bleachers right there with the, between those two light post. Yeah, I got the reading. He said they built a new school in 2013. And a couple bought it. I don't know if they're going to make something out of it. And then in 2017, these two jackass little 17-year-olds set fire to the old side that was built in 1913. I believe the other part was built in the late 30s. Thank you. like for handicapped people, they can use the, whatchamacallit. Pretty cool. Yeah, I might run up here to the school and take some pics. We'll see. All right, guys. I hope you like this. This was, like I said, I did this the other day, but I didn't get a good, a real good view of it. By the time I got down here, I was wore out. So, all right, guys. Hope you guys enjoy this. Hopefully, I'll get this up soon. Time you see it, probably be a week after I did this video. So, all right, guys, see you. Peace. Now, Lawrenceville High School in Lawrenceville, Illinois is the old one. It's pretty big. I think that means Lawrenceville Technical High School. I'm not sure. I think this is the newer part on this side. This is the old part. You can see the sign says high school on it. You can tell by the architecture, I think it's a little bit older. This whole side's burnt. This big old willow tree is awesome. I bet many a kid sat under here, made out. If you want to see the video of the inside, you'll have to watch it when I get it posted. I'll probably post this short, and about a week later I'll post the video. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace. This is the part I couldn't get to a while ago. I'm not going to go in it very far. I just kind of wanted to show you. So you can tell it's a lot older just by the rails, the handrails. Beautiful entrance. Yeah, this is like a gate that goes right back to the football field. See, there's a little building right there. This area was reserved for staff. Pretty cool. Well, I'm gonna go uptown, get some water, see if I can get some information. Some locals or something. Maybe the library's still open. I don't know. All right, guys. Peace. Love you.